to the band portion of We're Lenoir Music Fest 2017 that we're having tonight. Thank you very much for coming out and supporting these band kids. This is a sixth grade band. Their first piece we're going to be performing for you tonight is a grade one piece called Foxwood Overture by Ann McGinty. instructions. They're going to be getting out of But a couple things I would like to mention. First off, the fundraiser that we had last April, we will be receiving those things tomorrow afternoon. So those kids will be coming home for fundraiser things. And you know, they've got a lot of stuff ordered. If you wouldn't mind making sure that they have transportation home for that. So fundraiser items will be coming home tomorrow. Also, while I'm thinking about it, are there any board members, school board members present at the consulate? If you wouldn't mind me standing up and being recognized. Sure. I can't see you. Oh, there we go.
Hey!
Joseph's boss. All right. Thank you, Mr. Hogan. The sixth grade band has done a fantastic job this year. Mr. Jeff Warner has recently retired from the military. He comes in and he's been working with him some. And also Mr. Graver, who some of you might know as one of the high school, High Brighton High School band directors. He's been coming in the past couple weeks and working with him a little bit. And all the people that come and work with him talk about what a good group of kids these are. So they are well on their way to having success next year, seventh graders. On their last piece is actually a grade two piece, and they're getting ready for next year. And this is a piece called Imperium by Michael Sweeney.
Thank you.
This is the 7th grade band in concert tonight. And they went to a contest earlier this year in March, and they received the Queen Lenoir's 13th straight superior for 7th grade band in grade 2 music. And straight ones. So straight ones from all the judges. So they did a great job. Great job. Their first piece they're going to play tonight is actually something to get them ready for next year. And it is called Carolina Legends by Jim Swearingen. And it's one of their grade 3 tunes, which will be going, that's the 11th they'll be going in next year as 8th graders. Sam, why don't you stand up? Somebody can see you. Sam! is actually a swing piece. I always try to throw in a swing piece on the 7th grade to see who can handle it so far as jazz band connection. You can. And this one is called Diamond Joe's Riviera Club. And it's going to have Molly Triplett on drum set with a little feature. This is Diamond Joe's Riviera Club.
This band has been doing great. They've been doing a great steady climb
north, so hopefully we can keep that trajectory for next year, and they can earn another superior for Weir Lenoir Middle School, which would be great. But the last piece that the band's going to be performing today is going to be the old Chicago hit, 25 or 64, and it's going to have Jacob Norwood on drums this time.
Thank you.
This is the Wynn Lenoir Middle School Jazz Ensemble. And we've been fortunate to be able to meet every day. It's been a huge success. They actually went to contest and they earned a superior rating a couple weeks ago at Western Region Jazz Festival. And they went to Atlanta on the Atlanta trip and actually earned a superior down there. All straight ones, and had a great time and doing a great job this year. Their first piece is going to be a swing classic called Sea Jam Blues, and it's going to feature Aaron Reed on trumpet and Jasmine Valdez on tenor saxophone.
Thank you.
Thomas Kim at the 8th grade jazz band will be playing before the 8th grade concert band comes up and plays their set. It was made by Herbie Hancock, and it's called Chameleon. And it's going to feature Lindsey Green on alto saxophone and Jasmine Valdez on tenor saxophone. This is Chameleon. Their 33rd consecutive superior. which is awesome. All right, this is a great group of kids. This is a very, very, very good group of kids. And they had a special experience this year too. Beginning in January, I contacted a composer. His name is Michael Story. And Mr. Story has written band compositions his whole life. We talked about him doing a composition for the 8th grade band this year. And one of the things he likes to do is he loves to write for middle school bands, which is awesome. And last year, this band, as 7th graders, played a piece called The Pit and the Pendulum. And The Pit and the Pendulum was based on the Edgar Allan Poe story. So I talked to the band, and we had talked to Mr. Story about it would be really cool to base it on an Edgar Allan Poe story, short story. He said, that'd be great. So we talked about some of the ones, me and the kids talked about some of the ones that would be kind of cool. And we finally ended on one called The Mask of the Red Death, which if you're familiar with the story, it's all about Prince Prospero and his kingdom, and it's supposed to be the time of the Black Plague, which they call the Red Death, from the way it affected people. And in the story, it's all about class warfare and about, you know, personification and all these big literary terms. I don't know what goes on. I just think it's kind of cool. But in the story, they say that Prince Prospero had a castle on the hillside, and whenever the Black Plague is taking over his country, he decides that he's going to take 1,000 of his friends and put them up in this castle, and they're just basically going to have a masquerade ball and party until the Black Plague wipes out all the poor people, and then they'll step out and be fine. And throughout the story, they have the masquerade ball, and in this palace, there's 7 rooms of different color: orange, black, purple, green. And the black room is the final room in the house. And there is a clock that strikes the hour. They say it strikes the hour so loud that the band that was playing the masquerade decides that it stops. They have to stop every time it strikes the hour. And then a person shows up with a mask on, and they're dressed as death, and they start going between room to room, wiping out all the guests. And Prospero tries to find them to the final conflict in the black room, and the Black Plague, the Red Death, takes Prospero. So it's supposed to be about class warfare, and even though the rich are not affected by, or still can be affected by, disease and pestilence, even if they can defend themselves. So Mr. Story took this piece, and we've been Skype or hanging out sessions, hot Skype in the room with Mr. Story. We actually had one today, and it worked about a little bit. And so we've been having these sessions with him, and he really wants the kids' input on everything. So some of this stuff that you're going to hear tonight, they actually have input with Mr. Story about some of the things that happen in the piece. He starts out with a big fanfare. That's supposed to signify Prospero's castle that he's having the masquerade ball. Then it goes into a waltz. The waltz is supposed to signify the ball, the party time. During the party time, you'll hear the chimes start chiming the hour. When the chimes chime the hour, different players within the band will randomly stop playing until no one's left in the band playing, and you just hear the chimes. Then, to signify the 7 rooms, Mr. Story takes this one melody that's going to start with the clarinet section, and he's going to take it through different sections in the band for different tone colors. That's supposed to be the different colors of the room. And it's also the melody of death, of the Red Death. So that's going to go across the band, building to a climax at the end, which is supposed to be Prospero taking over, you know, confronting death, and death winning. All right, with the final hit of the chime. So this is the world premiere performance, as we were told this morning, of The Mask of the Red Death by Michael Story, written for the Lenoir Middle School 8th grade band. 15 minutes to help pack up stuff in the trailer, that would be
awesome, because we're going to take this stuff back tonight. And I know my wife is fussed at me because she said I don't have an original thought in my head about picking music sometimes, and I spit on her music. So, because she did this whole Michael Jackson thing, and I was like, oh, that's kind of cool. We got Beat It in the library, so I thought we would do Beat It. And then the kid said, no, let's do Eat It. So, by the kids, we're doing Weird Al Yankovic Eat It, okay? Which is really Beat It. So for the last time, this is the Weird Lenoir Middle School 8th Grade Band. And the last piece, thank you so much for coming out tonight. Thank you so much for supporting all the music and our school and our county with me and Carla. We are very appreciative of everything. Thank you so much.
Please support all of our schools here in Lenoir and Caldwell County. And please support our Caldwell Heritage Museum, 112 Vaden Street, Lenoir, North Carolina, 28645. Thank you.